One of the big differences about doing the ring in its proper format, as it were, with the whole cycle played out within the course of a week, is of course the development of the music through the four operas. And I think that is going to be an enormous difference for anybody who attends the whole cycle as it was conceived by the composer. I think that it's the development of the musical ideas that you hear, a lot of which you hear initially in Rheingold, and there are more added in Walküre. That you come back, and I mean, it's like when we're rehearsing, when we've been rehearsing each opera a year apart up to this point. Of course, you're coming back to the same thematic material, the same musical ideas, the same melodies, but they're transported, they're transformed, they're you know, altered to achieve a slightly different effect. And then each opera presents new ideas as well. And by the time you reach Götterdämmerung, the final instalment, you've reached a new sort of level of complexity. So I think that's perhaps one of the crucial things. The other element, of course, is the journey that each character makes. The fact that a character like Lorga, for instance, who only appears physically in Das Rheingold, the very first installment, the fact that his presence is felt in later subsequent operas, even if you don't see him as a character, I think that that makes much more sense when you're performing the whole cycle. Wagner's music's incredibly powerful because of its strength of gesture. I often sort of think to myself that if he were alive today, he would, not only would he be a film director, but he would be writing the music for his own films, and he would be moving everybody around the stage. I mean, his music and his sort of artistic intent has that sort of all-encompassing feel. So he would be staging a huge epic with lots of extras and a whole army of people and big scenery and mountains and seas and oceans and all the rest of it. The Orchestra of Opera North is used to being on stage, which is fantastic, because that means that gives them a confidence. I mean, I have to say that for some opera orchestras that are used to just playing in a pit, it can be sometimes a slightly unnerving experience to be up on the stage suddenly, but this orchestra is very used to that because it has a big symphonic program. But to be playing this type of music up on the stage in this format, so the stands are lit, the music stands are lit because we create darkness, so you're not just playing, it isn't a concert, you know, there's a lot more to it than that. It's a really thrilling experience. I mean, there are one or two members of the orchestra who I think they would admit that they really partly joined Opera North in the first place because they hoped that the company would do a ring cycle. It may have taken 30-odd years to do it, but I think some people are very pleased that at long last we're doing this absolutely enormous. It's the sort of the pinnacle of anything an opera company can do, really. I'd like to think that this way of doing operas of this type on the stage in a concert hall, but with a visual element that is all about clear storytelling, will encourage people to come. And I would be particularly pleased if it breaks down this inevitable barrier that some people feel, not just about opera, but also specifically about Wagner's music. And I think this is really important. If we've broken that sort of taboo, as it were, we've encouraged people to come off the street, come and see this, because it's a powerful experience. It's not about going to an opera, it's not about going and seeing a piece of art, it's a sort of palpable experience. I think if we've broken into that and just gone straight to the heart of the thing, we've presented hopefully very, very powerful music in a very clear way that speaks to anybody, I think that's great, and I would be very pleased about that.